board your Drake Interplanetary Craft. Your systems are online.
What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to Star Citizen, the Last Word Gaming Uberverse channel. So, I have an idea. I figured, I did tell you guys at one point in time, we were going to run through the ICC missions. And I figured, you know what? What better time to run through the ICC missions than when we have the Drake Buccaneer? That ship, if you didn't see the last video, go check it out, guys. It's on my channel. And if my channel's too boring for you, whatever, go watch it on somebody else's channel. I'll support other YouTubers only because this ship is worth watching. Go watch multiple videos on it. It is pretty legit. And suicide. But I figured, yeah, let's go do the ICC missions. Let's do them in the Drake Buccaneer. I think it'll be the most fun, and I might be able to, like, if you guys are still somewhat new to this game, I might be able to teach you a few things. There's a few tricks to some of the missions on there that'll probably help out. That's, you know, if I don't blow up over and over again. That's also a possibility with me flying. Select ICC. Quantum drive is now on. So what I'm doing is I'm gonna do this as a multi-part series. I'll probably do like ICC 1 through 3, then, you know, 4 through 6.
Random ship. Come in, random ship. Hi. Welcome to the neighborhood. Second class junior cartographer Tessa Bannister reporting in. I'm the eyes behind all the ICC scan probes in the area. What these little guys see, I see. Which, yes, means I can totally see you. Right now. Anyway, there was actually a reason to why I conned. I'm sort of not allowed to leave my post. Important jump point scanning and all. So, I was hoping you might be able to help me with something. If you have a second, could you check out these coordinates? Scans are saying something's there, but can't ID it.
All right, see, I'm going to do a multi-part series of ICC. The problem with ICC is if you quit the game and you come back, as for right now, you got to start all over again. So the quests aren't saving, so that way there's not a lot you can do in the game. You can just grind UEC credits over and over again by doing these. This first mission, if you're in a fighter, you can gun straight on in there to the blinking light, which is right there. But if you're not, let's say you're in something other than a fighter ship, it's a little bit longer way. But if you go down under and around the asteroid belt and pop up, nothing's ever going to attack you. Nothing spawns if you do it correctly. Let's see if I can do this correctly for you guys. So we're going to head down. Let's see, where's that, over there. Let's head down a little bit farther. I try to keep myself lined up with it. So what we're going to do now is kind of angle upward. Head on in. And if done correctly, nothing will spawn. See? No Ninetales, no pirates, no nothing. Nothing to worry about. Cakewalk. The first mission, if you do it that way, probably the easiest mission out there. And have you ever noticed, it always seems like you're a lot closer when you're in your ship than when you go out in EVA. Once you go in EVA, everything seems much farther away.
To those who find this, know that my journey has ended. It was finding my way here that made the path worth taking. I am glad that I can be part of your story too. Share it well. And safe travels.
Tessa here. Appreciate you looking into that scan for me. Between me and you,
you're welcome aboard your Drake
Interplanetary Craft.
Your systems
like a
are online.
Rock or something. But what you found was pretty neat too.
Yeah, that saber that you just saw pop up on the screen wasn't from me. It's from that Orbit Destiny person I had targeted. They spawned him in because they don't know the little secret way to get in there. So we're going to go back to ICC 849 and wait for the next mission. It usually only takes about a minute, 60 seconds. Doesn't take that long. The mission will pop up. Might even be there by the time we get back. Hasn't popped up yet. Just sit and wait.
Hey,
there it is.
Question for you. This sounds serious, right? It's coming from these coordinates. You should help if you can.
Quantum drive.
All right. Distress beacon. This is actually a distress call. So the distress calls aren't like the little box we just went and got in the last one. The distress beacon is actually a ship that's under attack. When you get out there, you look for the ship. Once you get to the ship, you're going to get a pirate that spawns. Pirate spawn, kill the pirate, mission complete. Sounds like cakework, right? Usually it's not too bad, unless you get a 350. Or, I also noticed last time, sometimes if you try to sneak through the asteroids and hit them from behind, they will loop around the other side, you'll never be able to get to them, and they will shoot the ship. If they shoot the ship and kill it before you get a chance to protect it,
Mayday, it's over. We are under attack.
So there's
Please
our
help.
Ship. And there's our enemy.
Do yourself a favor and turn around.
Got ourselves a saber. For the person that spawned the last guy. And so if you're doing the mission and somebody else shows up, your mission's not complete when you kill your ship. Your mission is complete when you kill all the ships in the area. And I learned that the hard way, because I was fighting one time doing the ICC mission and like five people spawned in, which means five more ships spawned in, which means my life got a lot harder. Flash. another successful mission. So, now with that done, we head back to ICC Probe, give it a minute, the next mission will pop up. You know, I've never actually came back to ICC directly after the mission like this. I didn't even, never, I know I might have, but I've never noticed she has something else to say if you get back here before the next mission begins. So I'm going to try and rush back here after each mission, just so we can hear what she has to say. The commentary is part of what makes the game what it is. So we'll head in here and pretend like we're gonna land, not like it's gonna do anything, but it'll start eventually. Distress beacon. Let's go check it out. So for some of the missions, like this one, we have multiple distress beacons, and when you get close, you'll kind of hear like a little humming sound, and then a beeping sound, and you want to follow the beep until the beep gets louder, obviously. If you play the game, you know that. If you don't, that's how you figure it out. If you're listening in, you'll hear the beeping get louder and louder and louder the closer you are to the distress beacon that you need. So, just because you're heading to a blinking light does not mean you're heading to the right blinking light. That sound right there, that's what we're looking for. Ninetales Cutlass. Missiles away. Now you do have to be careful when fighting in an asteroid field, because you can nail an asteroid and kill yourself. Or get blown up. That's a first. That is a first. You guys have witnessed the first death ever inside of the Buccaneer. And I play off camera too. There's a lot of like personal time I'm on here flying around, and the only time before that I was blown up wasn't by an enemy, and that's because I'm not counting it, and it's not because of a pirate player either. It was because I glitched out when refueling my ship at a Cryastro station, and I couldn't get the menu to get off of the screen, and I had to have somebody in the group that I was in blow me up so I could respawn back here. So as of right now, if you blow up in space, this happens. You can get your ship back for 2400 UEC. That is the insurance cost. Or you can wait 3 minutes and 50 whatever seconds is what it says. It's counting down, and each time it counts down some, the UEC amount will get a little bit less and a little bit less. The less time, the less amount you gotta pay. If you wait till it says zero, you don't have to pay anything. Like you just saw, it just dropped down to 2200. So we'll be right back. I'm gonna wait. I at least want to get this third mission done for you guys. And yeah, that was unexpected. I did not expect to blow up that quickly. I'm not sure if he was just laying that much into me, which I highly, highly doubt. But it is possible. Or if I had an asteroid, but at the same time I didn't think I was around any asteroid that I could have blown up. But yep, we'll be back in 3 minutes. Alright guys, we're back. So the time's almost done, but I did notice one of the problems that the game used to have was the monitors wouldn't work. You usually only got like one, maybe two monitors that work. If you guys are looking, every one of these monitors is working. So they did fix that. That's not really a problem anymore. Thank goodness, because that was a dreaded headache. Go back and try and complete this mission, shall we, without getting blown up this time? Now, that was a just a distress beacon type deal, like a little pad, like the first mission we did. So the mission's still gonna be there when we get out there. Now, if that was a rescue mission, you'll fail it. It'll say mission or objective failed. It doesn't mean you have to start ICC over again. You just have I call it a penalty time. Everyone else, it takes like 3 to 5 minutes, but the quest will eventually pop back up. That was almost terrible. I almost nailed Port Olisar. So I gotta fly around this spot. So we're gonna go to Comrade 275 right quick, so we can fly around the Crusader. The Crusader is the name of the planet that Port Olisar is in orbit around. Do I need to? No.
Right. You chose the wrong. No, I'm not missing with you.
Not part of my quest. Quantum drive is now on. Let's get out of here. Round two, guys. Round two. Just gotta fly through this asteroid belt again. Most time-consuming part of it all. Besides waiting for your ship to respawn from the insurance company. The death penalty right now is very chill, very, very relaxed. That death penalty when the game actually drops, though. Man, is it gonna be stupid.
If you know what's good for you, you'll stay out of this.
The Gladius again.
Missile locked.
multiples for a second there. Not sure who he's shooting at. I spin a lot. I've noticed whenever I'm in a dogfight, I spin. Craft on. Splash. Alright, that was a lot easier. There we go. See, the hard part after the fight on this mission is finding out where the sound's coming from all over again. Slow down on debris food. Sounds like it's coming from the one over here. Pirates, man. Got caught up with the pirates. You gonna say anything? ICC said something after every mission, but I'm guessing she doesn't say anything after this one, so let's go ahead and just shoot back over there, see what she has to say. That's all she had to say. Alright guys, well, that's going to be it for this episode. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Smash that thumbs up button. Drop comments down below.
Hey, you busy?
And,
I just got a comm. Here.
Yeah. Hit that subscribe button. And I'll see you guys in the next episode.